everyone. Welcome back. This is Valacar. Welcome to episode 6 of Material Energy Hypercubed. And also, by the way, Merry Christmas, everyone. Merry Christmas. So, I made some other progress on the game. Both some good and bad, I guess you could say. That on accident. So, first off, collected some stuff. I had several deaths. The room down below is horrendous. But, missions I have completed. Crystalline Surtress. Collected 200 of them. I collected well in excess of 200. Go ahead and claim that reward. I was hoping it would give me these, but of course they're not going to give them to me yet. Other mission. Climate control. Find one of my wrenches. That mission is complete. Okay, that's two missions complete. I'm the former one. Haven't collected enough stuff yet. Hoping that I'd get one of these. I guess I need to get core wool before I can get the stuff, or I may end up needing all these guys, which I have no idea where these would be around here. So let's go ahead and open these two bags. Alrighty, wow. Steam dynamo, magmatic, compression, reactant, and innervation dynamo? Interesting. And more retrieval nodes. Transfer node, and trash cans. I wonder. Of course I can't dispose of trash cans. I don't need them. And even though I don't need them, I can't get rid of them. So, yeah, I have 563 of the crystals. That's one of the statues, or one of the pillars of crystals down there in the bottom. So we'll go ahead and go down here. I have more. Still trying to grow the stuff for that quest. I guess I could pick those guys up. Not that I really need them. As you can see, there's lots of baddies down here, and they fall in this, in there, they turn into snowmen. So I cleared out this whole area. Ah, there's a couple of my deaths there. I fell off the stairs, I fell down there once, I fell down here. Fell down a lot of different places down in there. Then we go in here. I died all over the place in here. There's just way too many. And found this stuff here. Dense saltpeter. Dense potash. Is this almost all the stuff I need to make fertilizer? Oh no. Be a little bit too quick in my clicking on stuff. There's lots of stuff here. I'm not even sure if this really requires the pickaxe. I figured since it's dense, it did. I have a feeling there should be a chest buried in this somewhere. We'll dig through here a little bit. There's an empty hole. So we'll dig through a little bit, try to find a chest if there is one. So I'll be back in just a second. My pickaxe just leveled up to Grandmaster. So Grandmaster, didn't really do anything for it, and this Matic is accustomed plus, it got all the way up to full on it, and then flipped back over to clumsy, but it's clumsy plus. So I'm not sure if it'll get any other things as it progresses further. I guess we'll find out. Another thing I had noticed in the last episode, I like got near the edge and looked down and I actually thought this was water, and it turns out it's all the gelid cryolithium, which yeah, that would have been really bad if I were to jump off like I almost did. Okay, so I'm gonna collect a bunch of this stuff. I don't even know if I'm going to even bother collecting it all. It doesn't look like there's going to be anything under. But I'll be right back. Okay, everyone, I'm back. I cleared out this whole area over here. A very large amount of this magnesium and potash and saltpeter and phosphorus. So I could make a very large amount of fertilizer later on if I wanted to. Got the Enderman over here. Where is he? Oh, come on. Stupid Enderman, where are you? Guess I lost him. Oh well. So I did notice there's a chest in here. And I'd broken some of the glass so I could reach it. So this Invar helmet, gloves, and stuff. And I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. My audio system started acting up again, and for some reason my microphone wouldn't play unless I set it up the other way I had it set up, and now it's being a pain because I'm getting the same issues I was getting in the first episode with the sound. Okay, found another chest here. Two more good reward bags. Down here is the main item we want. It's down near where these stacks are. I don't know if there's anything inside of this one. Here, there's a chest just above, but I don't see anything down here. But inside of this skystone area here is another chest with the coral wall. So this will let us finish off this area. So we'll go back up. I can turn in the quest for that. And go up and check some stuff first. And show a couple of things I've done. I'm hoping the next area is a little bit easier to navigate than this one was. Hoping to get more carrots stuff. I have a decent amount of carrots in there. I know it only shows 64, but there's more than 64. For some reason it only shows maximum 64 in it. And same for potatoes. I have about a stack and a half in there. So I'll probably let this area be opened when I'm not recording so I can grow the remainder of the food that I want. So yeah, got another feather. These wild chickens, don't trust them. Almost died because of one of them. Probably wondering how I almost died to one of them. I'd like to reference Legend of Zelda for that, because that yellow chicken acts just like the chickens in Zelda. If you attack one of them, they all attack you. So yeah, that wasn't fun at all. Usually chickens don't attack, but this wild ones definitely will attack back. So okay, so I got some Invar armor. Last episode, I think it was last episode, I had found the bronze armor. And unfortunately, I don't have it anymore. I lost my bronze armor one of the times that I died somehow. I think what happened is I fell in the, who was that? Chests? That's a nice chest. I like those chests. Wish I would have saw those earlier. That's a perfect chest for over here. And I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. I figured go ahead and open these. Slotted book. My parcel. I don't know what that is. Book. Oak bookcase. Shelves. And bookshelf. Yeah. And then clay. That's so much easier than what I was going to do. So much easier. Because one of the things I was going to do to get clay, because I was needing to get some of this clay here for some projects, and all I had was this red clay. Red clay, you can't turn it into that. The only thing I could have done to get clay, which I was going to do it once I got around to it, was run it through a chemical decomposer to get the kaolinite. And the kaolinite could have been used to make 12 clay. there's a couple of reasons why I want the clay. One. Oh, does it not work? Oh, to me it doesn't work in this one. That's only unfired clay item. Oh no, what's the clay with... Oh, grout is one of the things. And porcelain is what I needed. I thought. Titanium dioxide. And kaolinite. Oh. Well, that is kind of upsetting. Because one of the items I wanted to make was it? I don't even remember where it was. Let me find it real quick. I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. So, it shows in here the Crucible by Ex Nihilo, but you can't select it. And same for the oaks, for the sieves. You can't really do anything with them. The barrels you can do. I was hoping to make a crucible so I could melt down some stone into lava, but that's not going to happen. So I guess the only thing I'm going to have to do is use it to make grout. So we'll do that. I have no idea what this book is for. Kind of feel a little upset over title description. I have no idea. I'll look into that later. Now we have two quests completed. Let's open it up. Eulorium. Reactor is full of energy, but in case you want to build bigger and need to make more energy, I should gather some in miners to light. Well, I haven't gotten it yet, but I did take the eulorium out of the reactor because I had an accident and I actually needed reactor casings. Wish I would have known about that. But that's okay. Chemical decomposer. Oh my gosh. Really? So I need to have a decomposer. Oh no. No. Maybe I can find one or get the stuff to make it in Miner's Delight. So, go ahead and turn this one in. And take a quick run around real quick. There's something I could try to make iron spikes. I haven't gotten enough iron for that or for the tool forge. Still need more carrots and stuff. Grout. There's gonna be more grout if I make how much grout? 20 grout. Guess that would explain why I got the clay. So I need gravel. Might as well do it this way. I'm not gonna make much difference in there. Sand. those, and four of these. Now give me eight. Now I'm gonna turn in that quest, get Grout. Gets me another reward bag. Now I have one for lava fabrication, for magma crucible. Some augments for it. Everything for the smeltery. So I have to make those items in a little bit. Bronze and Damascus steel. So I haven't found either of those yet. Some interesting items down here. Something else with quartz, probably going into the applied energetics. So let's see, I got anything else? Nothing yet. So we'll throw the grout in, let that cook. Throw that in there. Let me see, bricks in for right now. And go ahead and give ourselves another heart. And we'll take a quick look around, because reactor room, I made progress in here. I'd actually filled it all with the liquid cryolithium I collected. So my reactor casing temperature is 26 degrees. Nice and cold. So it's not using very much fuel at all. And I even dropped a couple of the reactor, couple of the control rods. I think I've dropped all of them down to 99%. Yeah, I dropped them all down to 99. I might just put the outer ones all the way in. That should work. Should still produce enough power to compensate for itself. Oh yeah, it's doing good. No problem. Sand's down to 24%. It's still producing decent amount of power. So we'll go over to the Victory Monument. There's the other side, Spatial. So let's take a little scenic route to get to it. So space-time wall. There's two. Next one's going to be one of those. Now notice that there's several that aren't named yet. Which I think that's kind of interesting. Throw the Envor in that and ready. And of course more potash. That's what everybody needs, right? Spatial IO now. Biosphere is still loaded. Biosphere is unloaded. Miner's Delight loaded. Okay. Let's go on up to the observatory and see what it looks like. I find we'll need some torches. Ore finder. Dense iron ore, core ore, poor coal, poor emerald, poor iron, and yellowrite. Lots of ores. This is gonna suck. All these zombies are all gonna come after me all at the same time. So yeah, there's lots and lots of ore. So we'll see what we can find here quick. That's a lot of ore. I think I'm going to light up this area pretty good. And hopefully I won't die. I'll be back. Okay, everyone, I'm back. I'm down to only 4 torches left. Managed to light up the top level of everything and kill a lot of stuff. Got a lot, mainly zombies, lots of zombies. Even got a carrot from one of them. And killed a witch. There's another witch. There was one in there. But we'll worry about getting the rest of this at a later time. And that'll be it for today's episode. I'm going to throw this stuff in the... in my storage for right now. And I will see you guys next time. And have a Merry Christmas, everyone. And goodbye.